Today we're going to communicate with outer space with the IC-705. So like many, when the Icom came out with the IC-705, I was really enamored with it. I thought, this fantastic radio, shack in the box, has HF, VHF, UHF. But after I got to thinking about it, I don't do QRP. And so whereas it was a great sounding radio, I kind of disregarded it for a long time. And I was looking at a Yaesu FT-991A because it was a shack in the box. It had HF, VHF, and UHF, and it had 100 watts. Unfortunately, COVID put a stop to most radio production. And about the only thing you could buy was the IC-705. And so I bit the bullet and bought one of these. I think it's even more expensive than the Yaesu FT-991. But nonetheless, I bought it because it was pretty much the only thing. And I needed a radio for traveling because I'm going to be traveling a lot over the next 6 months. And so I wanted to give this one a shot. Once I got it, I was floored with the capabilities of this radio. Really fantastic radio. I'm not a QRP person, so I wasn't all that interested in the QRP, and I don't do a whole lot of QRP. But I think people have really overlooked the VHF and UHF capability of this radio. All mode, 440, 2 meter, and that's perfect for the satellites. If it had full duplex, which it does not, but you can still use it with the satellites, and that's what we're going to do today. We're going to use it with the FM satellites. I'm actually going to work with the International Space Station, bounce a signal through the repeater there, and see if we can make some contacts. And I'll show you how to do that using a MacBook Pro with the software MacDoppler to correct for Doppler shift. MacDoppler is an app created by Dog Park Software. And I will leave a link below. So it does cost just under $100, so it's not a cheap software, but I like it. It works great for my use. And I'll leave a link down below. So download the software, install it per the instructions from the website, and once it's installed, come down and click on the icon, open it up. You come up to the top, select on Mac Doppler, slide down to Preferences, open up Preferences, and on this radio button, these are the settings that you really have to pay attention with. This is what's going to connect to the radio. Since even though the IC-705 looks very much like the IC-9700 as far as the screen and a lot of the functions and stuff, it does not have satellite mode in it. So you have to select an Icom radio that has similar functionality and modes to the 705, and that happens to be the IC-7000, so select the IC-7000. Now this part is a little bit tricky, the serial port. Sometimes the serial port will pop up with an option for the IC-705. Obviously, if that's on there, select it, but quite often I don't have this option on there, and if not, then I kind of have to experiment. One of these two, the USB modem selections, will usually connect up to the radio. But since I have the IC-705 feature here, we ensure that's selected. Baud rate, you gotta make sure the baud rate on the software is the same as in the radio. And this is critical, this is the CIV address. A2, I believe, is the CIV address for the IC-9700. I have an IC-9700, so I just kind of left it at with this. But I made sure that the CIV address inside the IC-705 was the same. So this A2 or whatever setting, whatever hex CIV address you want, make sure that it's the same in the software as it is on the radio. And that should get you connected up. On the radio, we go to Menu, and on the screen, Set, Connectors, CIV, and then here on the top one, the CIV address, I've got A2, Alpha 2, and then CI Transceive should be off, CIV USB echo back should be on. Closing out the MacDoppler preferences, we come to the main screen here. And down below is the satellite passes, the predictions with next pass, the rise, the length, the azimuth, and the elevation. Anyway, there's also the horizon feature, which you can use to actually track future. You can move the slider and it will slide forward in time and kind of predict what satellites are coming
up. NO84 is the next satellite and will be visible in 4 minutes and 5 seconds.
To get the computer to actually correct for Doppler shift on your radio, make sure that radio enabled is selected. And once it's selected, this is the indicator that will tell you that you got a good connection. The green flashing light means that you're good, that you've got a good connection with the radio. If it's orange or red, it means that it's not connected or it's not connected properly. Then turn off both the radio and close the MacDoppler, shut off the MacDoppler. Then start the radio again and then restart the MacDoppler and you should get it back to a green light. Because sometimes the sequence does matter when you're turning them on. If you come up to the, click on MacDoppler, go back down to preferences. If you look at modes, this has all of the satellites that you can possibly select. And we'll come down to the ISS. Open up the ISS and this will show you the options you have for the ISS. So it's got repeater VHF up and UHF down. It's got simplex VHF, packet VHF, packet UHF, repeater UHF up, VHF down, the old suit sat. So this is a lot of old stuff included with what's current on the ISS. Slow scan TV when they do have it. So these you enter these options, including over here the tone for if you're going to use the FM repeater. It's got a tone of 67 hertz. I've deselected all the satellites except for the ISS just so I can show you here. If you come down to the selection here, this is all the options that was on that grid that you entered the data for earlier. So right now it's on repeater VHF up and UHF down, which is kind of the standard for it right now. But slow scan TV, the Russians have been playing slow scan, broadcasting slow scan TV pictures. The packet VHF, they switch over to APRS periodically. And that's the packet VHF. But you select the mode that you want off of this. Some of these others are older modes that they don't really use anymore. But at least that's how you select what you want. Today we're going to use the FM repeater, which is active on the International Space Station. For aiming my antenna, I repurposed an old cheap drone landing platform that I had lying around. I painted on the degrees and azimuth around the edge of it so I could help aim. And then I sync it with my compass to make sure north is north. Set the antenna stand directly over the center of the platform. And there's my trusty elk antenna. I also have Arrow 2 antennas, which I love as well. The elk seems to be very portable. And the first thing I do when I start up is I turn on recording. Things happen so fast, I just don't have a chance of writing them down. And so I can always go back and listen to the recording to pick up stations that I worked.
The International Space Station is visible.
Hotel Lima 9 Golf Yankee.
Thank Hotel Lima 9, Golf Yankee.
Hotel Lima 9, Golf Yankee. This is Juliet Radio 6 Delta India in Okinawa. You are 5-9, over.
JR 6 Delta India, you're also 5-9 in Pyeongtaek, South Korea.
Okay, so HLIM GY, JR 6 DI, thank you, 73.
Hotel Lima 9, Golf Yankee, Japan.
X-ray. Hotel Lima 9 Golf Yankee, you're 5-9.
Hotel Lima 9 Golf Yankee, Japan. Japan 02 X-ray
05. JK 2 X-ray Kilo 5-9 Pyeongtaek, South Korea.
QSL, thank you, 73. Hotel.
This is HL 9 Golf Yankee QRZ.
HL 9 This is Japan 76 Delta Romeo Quebec.
Japan Romeo Quebec, year 5-9, Pyeongtaek, South Korea.
Okay, thank you for a nice contact from Okinawa. Thank you.
7-3.
International Space Station is no longer visible.